I threw out Keen Hitting. I mean, we'll be hitting Keen like, oh, that's someone's guts falling to the bone.
So shit is going to hit the fan. But not yet.
So I'm still high.
Yeah, we can't really see that. We can't really see any of that, so.
So you just
think
keep eyeing.
Logically, we can do is keep eyeing until something really bad goes down, like we need.
These guns start fighting.
These two dumb schmucks get out of the fucking room.
So the guards are on fire, you're searching.
Actually, God, what was going on?
Guards just on fire.
Yeah. Anyway, now the majority wife is on fire too. This one guard, once he's eventually, he tries to stab a Johnny Good that's hugging his decapitated wife. Well, he stands and stabs him in the back. And he succeeds, and his spike like really goes right through into the woman he was hugging and all. So the one I'm doing is like cheering.
Cheering into the open belt?
It was college like 3 seconds ago.
Oh, fuck you, Andrew. You fucking
you're not messing with me.
So, well, basically, I assume I smell the fire somehow. And smoke coming in.
Yeah, the smoke.
Yeah,
I remember that.
The huge amount of screaming and everything.
Yeah.
Well, I like peek out and I check either the clear path to the door.
The clear path? No, the entire hallway up until here or something.
But
like filled with flaming guards and burning alcohol.
I peek out of my hiding spot on the delivery table. And like,
underneath the delivery table, you only see like guards on the floor.
Does the guard like respond to me somehow? I don't know.
Hey, what's up? Yo!
No, he's just like,
do you know what I watch it?
He's like just enjoying his moment of insanity.
Ah, come on!
What the heck? And he's bleeding to death, like, by the way, and just like.
I'll walk up the guard and basically type 7.
And that's okay? So we can't kill a woman?
I want to spare this woman, but.
Yeah, so the guy standing up, moving to the guy next to the guard.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I think it was that the nurse.
Yeah, there's plenty of room.
Alright.
Yeah, you stab him and his guts fall out.
Do I hear dead guard? Not like, oh, I'm dead now, but I mean, you know.
Yeah, obviously he mentioned that, like, yeah. That, like, with the guts out. And
there you go, yeah, but I can't. Well, I mean, I threw a keen hitting, I mean, we'll be hitting keen, like, oh, that's someone's guts falling to the floor.
Yeah.
That would be so cool.
Let's just say I'm cautious, since I don't really know, like, with the burning things, I can't hear from inside, but so, I just try and take one arm out of my disguise and see if I can peek through and see what's going on with the room.
Okay, you peek through, you see a dead guy lying on top of his wife with a pipe in his back and another guard like lying on the floor with his guns all over
him. Anymore?
What?
He killed him today, his wife.
No,
the other dude stabbed Johnny through his wife.
Yeah, then you stand there like, cheer, and then you kill him.
Yeah.
And the door open, you hear like the guards rolling on the floor in despair, like, ah, oh, the thing's hurt, ah, oh, Molly!
Can I still move enough to see what else is going on? Like, can I open further and perhaps take a look outside the room?
Yeah, you don't see much more than guards like running, okay. Like, crawling around in planes.
Okay, okay. I don't know, I'm going to wait to see what he does. Gonna take the guards approach.
Sure.
So, in the meantime, like, a messenger returns. And he finally has a firefighters with him. So then they like have these buckets of water that they're passing through.
Pouring this lowering bucket of water on the burning alcohol, it can spread more.
Well, they
don't know about the alcohol yet. They said like, whoa, this fire is spreading quickly. So they like throw some water in the alcohol and finally the alcohol spreads some more. So like the alcohol floats. Starts floating into this room. In this room.
Fire on the other nurse dies.
So there's like small fires starting to fill the doors here.
Oh, okay.
And the guy just couldn't not see ghosts, so like, keep...
Keep on the wall. Keep on the wall. Whatever, not my morning, well.
Well, anyway, this is the chain of firefighters, so I'm like...
They all blind? I mean, is this some kind of sin in this entire world? Like, people are all blind.
It's a protocol.
When get a job, lose an eye.
So you fight it to be four while the other fight it's protocol.
Yeah, if it doesn't work, more than nothing.
Okay, figure out some way to put out the fire.
Alcohol?
Yeah, I suppose still stuck in there.
Like, so make some kind of strength check in him and his dead wife, so.
Well, yeah. Fragile things.
Yeah, okay, you succeed in taking spare and, like, feeling your muscles pumping and.
Oof, awesome. Yeah. I'm a gentleman, I don't fucking make me. Yeah, no.
And I use a spare, like, I don't know, like, the new stuff, like, the weak spots in the wall.
Yeah, you can't do that much anymore. She already took out spare.
So yeah. You, take, like,
you can try to find a weak spot, you can't like really...
It's a tire, man! She's condemned with a tire!
You can start looking for weak spots in the wall by like 10
minutes. There are some spots in the wall that are obviously like more hollow than others.
Okay, good. That's already some information.
Alright.
Okay, next one.
Do I have can I see if he finds some weak spots?
You see him like poking into the wall, like don't know why he did it.
Gate, not a madman.
So I don't have a recollection of he's trying to find weak spots.
The only thing you know is like the spot he touched last.
Meh, yeah.
Touching the wall.
That might be a little. Then I just scope around for the best possible weapon to pick up if necessary.
Well, the scissors are stuck in the dead guard's neck.
Oh, no,
in his hypothalamus.
Isn't that nice? Isn't there anything close by I can use as a weapon?
I have a short sword.
Yeah, but you're invisible.
Yeah.
And you're not in his mind.
There's a flow in that and he doesn't know you.
It's been a very pleasant trip so far. Then I just scope the best possible and fastest route towards the scissors. I just map it out in my head.
You're right next to the guard, man. This is the guard.
Then I scope out the best possible way to get to them, if necessary.
Okay. You're there.
No. Just like, in my mind, if there's trouble, the best possible way I can drag the weapon, because I'm still in hiding.
Oh.
I'm trying to keep in hiding, but if shit goes down, I want to be able to have a weapon ready as fast as possible.
You're ready in action.
Well, yeah, sort of.
Like,
I had it in action for when shit goes down.
The for when shit goes down action.
What are you ready in action for? There's a freaking fire outside of the hallway. No,
if shit happens and shit comes towards me, I can take the freaking scissors and cut whatever is coming in his head off.
What's this shit?
In the meantime, like, these stupid fuckers continue, like, putting water on the fire. And, like, the fire keeps spreading because of the alcohol. So it comes closer. In the room, in every room.
Hey John, have you ever heard of cause and effect?
Here, like...
Wow, you're queer!
Here, like, the baby beds start catching fire, and there's like a couple of babies dying.
Awesome!
The fire spread here.
Hey, I was on the baby side for a while. They fucking tell.
Actually, the fire is starting to spread to the dudes, throwing the water on it. So they're, like, on fire.
But
they're still doing their job.
Oh, I'm fine again.
In the meantime, like mental patients that were rioting exit the mental ward.
Into more fire.
They were on fire, but they're like running like mad, jumping over the
guard. They did that at the start too. I was trying to save them and they tried to fucking eat me.
This knife is not very good.
Your free food is hurting mine.
Like,
what the fuck, man? I'll serve you this free food. Okay.
That's
some sturdy packaging,
just
man.
Use the teeth, man.
I'm trying! Look!
It'll get through.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just... Okay, so yeah. Good.
Plus 700 experience.
Anyway, so now we're all in this darkish room. What do you do?
Okay.
You're like planks, like.
Well, I'm looking for a door. I told you 5 times.
Yeah, oh, I'm looking for a door. Well, yeah, there's a door, but it seems like locked.
It's dirty.
Yeah.
What was it again?
Like with all the babies.
Oh, the maternal wash, yeah.
With all the babies.
This was building X, you don't know what it is, because like you escaped right here.
What
was it? Through the window?
Never mind.
And you see like a large forest. Well, like not that large, because like
at some
distance, you can see there's this huge wall, like, I don't know, the wall of China or something. That seems like very.
Oh, great, China. I hate China.
So. What do we do? We can either like explore the forest towards here or try to do something with the wall.
As we observe the wall, is there something leading towards an exit that we can see or nothing discernible?
No, it's just this huge wall that's like.
And there's no like checkpoints, like, you know, guard towers, stuff, anything like that. It's just one big ass wall.
Just one big ass wall. And just standing here and you can only see a large wall in the forest.
We should quickly check the surroundings. And see if there is an exit.
Well, at least we're out of the death threat.
We're not out of the woods yet!
At least we did.
Yeah.
You get it?
I do. Yes, I get it.
I see the edge of the forest!
Anyway, you can see, however, that like the mental watch is on fire still.
Yes, yes. We'll move away from the fire.
So there's a fire and the tunnel one's on fire too. So on the right is the fire agent.
I'll move to this direction and we'll check the surroundings there. We have to find an exit someplace.
I'll say I ate myself.
You what?
I ate myself.
Oh yeah. You did that.
Yeah, the baby's dead anyway.
There you go.
And I'm Richmond. I'm huge.
And that's your hat.
Okay. So, checking surroundings. Anything new developments as we try and go there?
Well, as you move through the woods, you like encounter a skeleton.
Yes.
A guy that obviously tried to escape but didn't find a way out.
Motivation.
As a backpack.
I suppose I search it.
Okay, so you find 2 fetuses. And
how many unborn are they?
This is like fetus central.
A scroll I named Scroll of Gag.
I'll take that.
No, actually, you can't use it, so.
And just because I can't use it, I can't take it? I'm searching.
Okay, maybe
why can't
they
use scroll?
What?
Why can't they use scroll?
Because I'm a halfling rogue and I don't use magic, it's also.
Oh, okay, I guess.
We'll sort it out later, I just take whatever is valuable to me for the moment.
Yeah, and there are like 2 bottles with a greenish liquid. Besides that, there's like a usual crap, like something to make fire with, a flintstone.
What do you get?
Some towels, clothes.
If it's handy for like a flintstone or anything like.
Lighting towels.
What? Towels?
Yes,
towels. Okay, isn't it like a backpack entirely? Something like. Let's just say I take the entire contents. I don't like.
Yeah,
I don't dismiss like. Oh no, I don't need these 2 fetuses. I'll just take my time and throw them out of this backpack. I mean.
Yeah, I can just take the backpack.
Okay.
The backpack is intact.
Okay, I'll
just
do that.
You don't have your stuff yet.
Yeah, indeed. See, that's why I was going to take it.
We're all set. Question. Whatever I'm wearing right now is invisible with me, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
If I take it off and put it back on, does it become invisible again?
No. If you take something off now, it stays visible forever.
Forever. Good, absolutely.
Okay then, I take off my robe and put it on again. You know, it makes me
really awkward.
More or less visible.
Okay, so now you see floating clothes in a hand.
I suppose we move on. I mean, we're not going to stand above this course for half an hour.
You end up like, it's not like this, but you end up encountering like
the other side of the wall.
The other side of the wall. And there's still this passage here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There just has to be an exit somewhere. I mean, everybody agrees with me on that, right? Close.
Yeah, you see, very keen on like trying to get us out of there.
Yeah, sure, but
I can just take off my robe and be invisible.
I can just get naked.
Naked and invisible.
Start climbing too.
What?
But using the same route he was, the easy route.
It's not easy at all, come on. Climbing like a corner of a wall or climbing a tree?
There's windows.
6 foot high. I mean, six meters high.
Yeah, he's a bit more nimble, so he left them too bad. But
Roll then.
Ah, well, what the hell am I gonna do then?
You can use a rope to gate wings and fly.